You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we do a Azure Cognitive Search overview, high level, what you can do without any code. It's pretty amazing. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show, where we're going to do an Azure Cognitive Search overview. I got a special guest with me, Luis. How you doing, my friend?
I'm doing great, Seth. It's a pleasure to be with you.
So tell us who you are and what you do.
So I am a program manager in the Azure Cognitive Search team. And well, as a program manager, I worry about the design and the definition of the product and making sure that you know about it.
Fantastic. So why don't you give us an overview of what Azure Cognitive Search is?
Thank you, Seth. So Azure Cognitive Search is a platform as a service that allows you, even if you are not a search expert, to be able to create wonderful search-enabled applications for web, for mobile, maybe for your line of business or enterprise applications. That's what it can do for you. So as we can see on this slide, Azure Search allows you to, or it has all these kind of capabilities that you will expect in a search application today. People have got used to all these kind of capabilities when they go look for restaurants, or maybe they want to look for a job, or maybe they want to buy something. Search boxes are in every application that you use every day. And customers have come to expect these capabilities in your application as well. They want great search applications. Great search applications are really more than just trying to match a term into, you know, character for, by character into each of the documents that you have in a database. They really expect a higher level of experience. Imagine if you are creating a jobs site and you add your search query right there. People expect to find results even if they make mistakes. Let's say that they may misspell a word or a term. They still want to be able to find the content. Also, as they are typing, they will expect to see type ahead capabilities such as autocomplete, such as synonyms, and suggestions to be supported as part of your query. Also, people want support for facets and filters and all kinds of other capabilities that allow them to drill a little bit deeper into the type of data that they care about, so they can get really to, in this case, to the job that they care about. But just like this, there could be many, many other capabilities, such as geospatial queries or the support for highlighting, snippets, paging, and different ranking algorithms. And the beautiful thing about Azure Search is that even if you're not a search expert, you have all of these capabilities available to you.
So this is awesome. But as I'm looking at this this stuff, and let me go back to your screen, this all looks like stuff that can come out of a database. What if you don't have data that's nice? Is there something we can do with that?
That's a great question, Seth. And you are right. In this case, this specific example is connecting, let's say, to a SQL database or maybe a Cosmos DB database that has all this information. But in many cases, your data is not structured, right? It's really completely unstructured. And one of the new capabilities of Azure Cognitive Search is the ability to be able to connect to different types of data sources, whether they are structured or unstructured, and be able to understand the content inside those data sources. Let's say, for instance, that I have, let's say, blob storage. That's completely unstructured content. I'm essentially just putting any type of document in there, right? Like PDFs, PowerPoint files, Word documents, Excel spreadsheets, all kinds of different types of file formats. And I want to be able to find those documents. So completely unstructured content, I want to be able to find it still. So the way that we can do this with Azure Cognitive Search is through a concept that we call indexers. And this indexers is essentially the pipeline that I'm showing you on this slide right now, where they have document cracking skills to understand the different file format, to extract the content out of those files, the text, the images, the metadata in those files, and then be able to enrich this information through what we call skills, essentially AI algorithms, machine learning algorithms. And we have a variety of built-in algorithms and the ability for you to plug in your own algorithms as well. This allows you to have structured content now, what we see in the diagram as the enriched document. And now we can go and index it just like we, just as if we were indexing structured content.
So this is awesome. I like everything you've showed me so far. Can you show us what this actually looks like in practice?
Yes, I will. So let's actually go to this my Azure portal. I am here in my Azure account, and I'm going to show you how you get started. Essentially, once you have your Azure subscription, you just go and create a new resource. We're going to search for search. And I found Azure Cognitive Search right here. And I could go ahead and create a service. I am not going to do that right now because I already have one. So I'm going to one that I am already using. So we're going to actually do an exercise where we're going to import data from a data source and look at the files in there, extract information from them, and then index it without having to write any code. But that doesn't mean that you cannot do everything that we're going to do programmatically. So you can see here, I click the import data flow, and now I can select the type of data source that I want to connect to. And by the way, you can see that I have structured content such as Azure SQL databases or maybe a SQL server on a virtual machine. But in this case, we're going to actually deal with unstructured content. Like I'm going to connect to Azure Blob Storage, and I can navigate to one of my accounts that has a set of files. So I have Luisca Store. I know in there is a files container. I'm just going to select it. And I am going to give this a name. I'm going to call it demo data source. All right. And then as a next step, I am going to add or define what are the enrichment steps that I want to apply to my data, because this is completely unstructured content. So the system already detected the schema of my information, and now I can essentially attach a cognitive services resource to my subscription. One important thing here is that you need to create a cognitive services resource in the same region as your Azure Cognitive Search resource, so that we essentially power all these new machine learning algorithms. So I am going to do that. Then I'm going to add the exact enrichments that I care about. A lot of my files in Blob Storage are, for instance, I have PDF files there, and they need to be cracked. But once you open a PDF file, sometimes they are nothing but a collection of images. So I am going to click this checkbox to enable OCR and essentially take all the textual representation of them and put it into a merge content field. And then I can apply different skills. I'm going to select all of them just for fun. I'm going to even translate some of them into English if they're not in English already. But essentially, there are a bunch of built-in skills that you can select. And here, just by setting checkbox, it's going to do quite a bit of work on each of these files. I click Next to move forward. Oh, sorry, it's complaining that I don't have a unique name for my skill set. So let me call it demo skill set.
So as you're doing this, you're basically pointing it to a place where there's just blobs of data. You're saying anytime you get a new blob or thing, run this stuff over it to see if you can get information out.
That is correct. So that, and I am telling or defining what are the steps that should be applied to this information as it enters my data source. So in the next step, I am going to customize the search index where the information ends. And then I will describe what the indexer properties are, where I actually can tell it how often to go look for changes and things like that.
Got it.
So okay, so we're going to go to the next stage where I get to define the index properties. And here you can see that it automatically, for instance, identified a bunch of metadata related to my files. So for instance, I want to say, oh, you know, there is the metadata storage name or the name of the file in storage. I want that to be retrievable. Maybe I also want that to be a searchable field. So I could select the attributes of each of the fields as they enter my new index. So let's call this the demo index. And as I could, for instance, say that locations and people, organizations should be filterable and facetable. So I can select each of those things. We even have interesting analyzers for different languages. You can see that because I translated all the text to English, it automatically identified that as an English field. And therefore, it selected the English analyzer. We support both Lucene and Microsoft Research produce analyzers. And this allows you to understand really like the intricacies of language. So for instance, if I were to search for mice, that's a very, character-wise, it's a very different word from the term mouse. But conceptually, they are similar, right? One is just the plural of the other one. So these analyzers solve some of those problems with the language. So I'm going to click next to create an indexer. And let's give it a name, demo indexer. And this is what you were saying, right? Maybe I just want to do that once, or maybe I want to do it on a schedule like hourly, daily, or define a custom schedule. So here I can go and just, let's just do it once for this demo. I'm going to submit it. And under the hood right now, all these machinery is getting set up, right? Think of the machinery to crack open all these different documents, machinery to OCR them, to translate them. And all this orchestration is going to start happening soon. And then we can see the results once the data is indexed. So I can go and see each of my indexers. And I can see, for instance, we call this the demo indexer. Right now, this one, which is currently in progress as it is starting to index each of the documents.
I see. So the indexer's job, and as you refresh, I'll go back to our faces so we can talk about this. So yes. As the indexer's job is basically to pull those blobs out and then run all of those intelligent things over that document. And you said something interesting. You said document cracked. It's cracked open. What does that mean? Is that, when I heard the term first, it kind of threw me for a loop.
Yeah. So it's an internal term that we use called document cracking, where it's just like cracking a nut. You know, you want the meat out of the nut, right? You want to eat the substance inside the shell of the nut, right? So think of each of the documents that you have, like PDF documents or Word documents, even JSON documents or HTML. Each of them have, let's say, a textual representation inside of them, right? So you want to extract the text out of them. Some of them have images as well. So maybe you want to extract, let's say, the images inside a PowerPoint presentation, for instance, right? And not only that, but you may want to do further processing with those pieces of information, and that's what the next stage or the skill set is for. So, for instance, you may want to OCR or get the handwritten or printed text recognition out of the images that you extracted out of the document.
I see. So basically, the indexer is basically like the hammer that stamps out all the stuff out of the document, cracks it open, runs a bunch of intelligent things, and then stuffs it into the index. What can you do with searching? I'd love to see a sample of, like, once it's all cracked and put in the index, what kind of search things can you do?
Yeah. So if we go back to the portal, you will notice that our indexer just finished cracking the documents. And sometimes there are some warnings, for instance, if some document didn't have a particular field, but there were no errors in our indexer. So we can actually go look at the demo index. So I'm going to go to the indexes tab and click on demo index. And I should be able, you can see the fields as we defined them earlier and so forth, right? But I can also search here. So, for instance, let's say if there is any document that mentions Satya Nadella, right? And this is some letter that he wrote today. It's a very humbling day for me, blah, blah, blah. So I can see the results that came out of this, right? And for each of these documents here, let me just kind of scroll down. I can see information extracted from the documents, such as the people, the organizations, locations and so forth that were extracted automatically from this document. I don't know, let's search for something else. These are just documents that I found in my hard drive. So let's see something on bots perhaps. So you can see here I had some text, Bienvenido al Futuro in Spanish. I gave some presentation in Spanish. And just to show the translation of that, just that'll be interesting to see. You can see the translated text that was extracted as well. Welcome to the Future, Cognitive Services and Bots by Luis Cabrera, right?
That's really cool.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So that means that I can find the documents. Even it doesn't matter if I use English or Spanish in this case, it will still find the documents, right? So that's how you query the information. Of course, you can do it through APIs, right? So this actually shows the request URL that I will use. And in this module, we're just showing you how to do this, you know, from the portal. But in future modules, we'll show you how to do this programmatically and how to define the skill set and so forth. This is just a brief introduction into Azure Cognitive Search.
Well, fantastic. Thank you so much for this introduction. Luis has said, we have other episodes that we're putting together to see if we can get a whole set of these so you can also dive into Azure Cognitive Search. Thank you so much for spending some time with us, my friend.
It's my pleasure always, Seth. Thank you so much.